Welcome to Learn Commerce PU Online Classes. Don't forget to like our video and subscribe our YouTube channel for all the updates.
Welcome to our first PU Computer Science online classes. Now, in today's class, we are going to complete after the conversion, each and every conversion, maybe from octal to the hexadecimal conversion or maybe hexa to the octal conversion, depend on the rules we followed, each and every rules, just to make the conversion from octal to the hexadecimal conversion. Now, in today's class, we are going to complete the next very important question, 5 marks question, that is from the question heading is the subtraction using one's complement. Okay, the subtraction using one's complement. So in this case, the most important heading, now the heading is the subtracting. Okay, here the subtracting smaller number from a larger number, that means how we are going to make the subtraction. We need to make the subtraction, that is from smaller number from a larger number. Clear this one? The smaller number from a larger number using the one's complement. So now the steps, what are the steps we need to follow? The first step, find one's complement of the smallest number or smaller number. Okay, first of all, we need to find out the one's complement of the smallest number. Clear this point here? As we know that, how to find out the one's complement of the smallest number? As we know that, by changing all the zeros to ones and all the ones to the zeros. So like that, we can find out the ones complement of the smallest number. And second point, add ones complement to the larger number. After finding the ones complement of the smallest number, we need to add the largest value to the smallest number. Laterwards I will tell. Now just I am going to read these steps. The second step is the add ones complement to the largest or larger number. Third step, remove the final carry and add it to the result. If I tell now, you can't understand what's the meaning of step 3. Remove the final carry and add it to the result. So clear this point here? Okay, now let's complete one by one all those solution. This step 1. So in this case, before going to make the solution, now let's, what's the question? The question is the subtract 15 from 23 using the ones complement method. Okay, so this is the question. The question, again I am going to repeat, the question is the subtract 15 from 23 using the ones complement method. So as we know that the 15 and 23, we can't make the conversion. We can't we can say that the 15 is the smallest number, 23 is the largest number, but before that only we need to divide such value 15 and 23 by 2. So just only I want to divide the number 23 as well as the number 15 by 2. So when you are going to divide 23, we can say that 2 elevens are 22, 1 is the remaining. Okay, now the actual value is the quotient value is the 11. So when you are going to divide, 2 fives are 10, that means the 1 is the remainder, and next one is the 2 twos are 4, actual value is 5, so 1 is the remainder, and 2 ones are 2, correct? No any remainder, as we know that we need to divide until the quotient becomes 0, correct? No, we need to divide until the quotient becomes 0, and we know that the first remainder is called as the LSB, the last one is called as the MSB. And how we are going to write? We need to write from the MSB to the LSB. So just I am going to write the answer of 23 as 10111. Clear this point here? So now later words, let's see. I already written the answer of 23, that is equal to 10111. Correct na kya? So now let's the division of our number 50. So when you are going to take the number 50 and when you are going to divide by 2, so 2 7s are 14, 1 is the remainder. Correct no? 2 7s are 14, 1 is the remainder. Now when you are going to divide the value 7, whether it will go? No. 2 3s are 6, 1 is the remainder, and 2 1s are 2, 1 is the remainder. Clear this point here? The 1 is the remainder, and later next one, as we know that the 1 value not going to divide by 2 here, so we need to take the 0, and whatever the quotient value of 1 is that, we need to write it here. So we know that the first remainder is called as the LSB, last one called as the MSB, and we need to write as the value, that is from MSB to the LSB. So I am writing as the 1111. Clear this point here? So 1111 here, but actually I used the value 0, where because here when you are going to think about the number 23, how many numbers are there? 1 2 3 4 5, correct? No. So just to make it, that means equal value, so just I used the value 0. So this value I also want to write in our 15 number here. So the value as the 01111. So clear this point. So this is the value of the 15. Clear this one? Okay. Now after completing this step 1, if they give one directly the number 10111, that means no need to make the division by 2. If you won't get the number, maybe if you are getting the number 1523, on that time we need to make the division by 2 here. If you directly, if they provide the number 10111 and 01111, so that means no need to make the division by 2. Clear this point? Okay. Now later next one, step 1. So what about this step 1? This step 1, find 1's complement of the smallest number. As we know that when you are going to compare 23 and 15, whichever is the smallest, the 15 is the smallest. So just only I am going to write the value 15. Whatever the value I got here, the value 01111. Okay, and such value I need to make the, that means the 1's complement of the smallest number. So what's the 1's complement of the smallest number? As we know that whatever the number is there, we need to change 1 to 0, 0 to the 1. So 1 and 4 0 will get. Correct no? In this case, so hege nan chain madido namge gottide 0 iddadu 1 ge change aagtade, 1 iddadu 0. So like that here 4 1's are there. So just I completed to the 4 0. So that means I completed the step 1. Find 1's complement of the smallest number. So this is the step 1. First of all, we know that 15 is the smallest. Whatever the, after the division, whatever the answer will get, such answer I return here. And what's the answer is that, such one I need to convert to the 1's complement. Clear this one? Okay. Now step 2. So what about the step 2 here? The step 2 is the, that means add 1's complement to the larger number. Add 1's complement to the larger number. As we know that now I am going to take the answer of the 23. So 10111. Okay. And whatever the answer I got in step 1, such answer also I need to add it. Clear this one? So the answer is the 1, and here 4 zeros are there. Clear this point? The 4 zeros are there. So this is our second step. That the second step is the add 1's complement to the larger number, and later next one after that I am going to add. As we know that 1 plus 0, the binary arithmetic table, 1 plus 0 the value is 1, 1 plus 0 the value is 1, okay, 1 plus 0 the value is 1, 0 plus 0 the value is 0, and 1 plus 1, as we know that when the value is 1 plus 1, that is equal to 10. Maybe if you get the value 1 1 plus 1 plus 1, that is equal to 11, correct? No, but here just only the value 1 plus 1 is there, so we need to write the value as the 10. Why I am writing the 10 directly? Because after that no any values are there. So this is the that means here we can say that this is the addition of larger number to the smallest number. So add 1's complement to the larger number. So clear this point here. And later next one, the step 3, remove the final carry and add it to the result. Remove the final carry and add it to the result. So remove the final carry, this is the third step. Remove the final carry and add it to the result. So we need to remove it, okay, and again we need to add it to the result here. So now just to get the answer of our subtraction 15 from 23 using the 1's complement. So now we know that 1 plus 1 the value is 10. So 1 is carry, okay, 1 plus 1 the value is 10, 1 is carry, 1 plus 1 the value is 10, so 1 is carry, so 1 plus 1 the value is 10, 1 is carry here. And later next one, after that we can say that as we know that 1 plus 1 the value is 10, 1 is carry, again I added 1 plus 1 value is 10, clear this point, again I added 1 here, so 1 plus 1 the value is 10, so again I am going to add, so 1 plus 0 the value is 1, 1 plus 0 the value is 1, and this one if you want you can add it, it is not necessary to use, okay. So this is the answer of the 1's complement of the answer, 1's complement of the 15 from 23. So how to find out whether our answer is proper or not? So we can say that when you are going to subtract 23 minus 15, the value will get as the 8, correct? No, the 23 minus 15, so the actual value is the 8 here. When you are going to subtract, we will get the answer as the 8. So when you are going to find out our hexadecimal table, in our hexadecimal table when you are going to find out the number 8, you will get the answer as the 1000. Clear this point here? So you will get, because the zero value, that is equal to no value in this case here, so just only you have to write the answer 01000, otherwise we can take the answer just only as the 1000. Clear this one? So both answer are also correct here. So how to find out whether the answer is correct? That means when you are going to subtract 23 minus 15, we will get the subtraction answer as the 8, and when you are finding in our hexadecimal table, in our 8th number, the value will get as the 1000. So like that we can find out the answer whether it's a proper or not. So clear this one, how we need to find out. Now let's, after that we'll complete the next answer or the next question of the 1's complement. Now after completing, now let's the second question now, that is about our subtraction using 1's complement. The same rules and regulation I am going to follow here also. So the first side point is the subtracting a smaller number from a larger number. As we know that what are the steps we need to follow? First of all, find the 1's complement of the smallest number. Find 1's complement of the smallest number. Second, add 1's complement to the larger number. Third one, remove the final carry and add it to the result here. So whatever the carry we need to add to the result, such step is called as the end around carry, okay. So now I am going to start the question here. So first of all, the question is the 11001 and 10011. Whether we need to make the subtract, that means whether we need to make the division here by 2? No, we no need to make the division such number by 2, because here directly they provided, they given the number. So maybe if they given the number in this manner, maybe the 10 and 5, that means sure we need to make the division by 2 here. But in this case, if they providing the number directly, no need to make the division. Okay, now next thing about as we know that when you are going to think about the number 11001 and 1001, so this number is the smallest number. How you are thinking? So here we can say that the 0011, okay, we need to take, and the next number is the 1001. When you are going to know about our hexadecimal table, in our hexadecimal table as we know that, so how we need to complete, that means our binary equivalent, that is equal to the 4 bits. Clear this one? In one group totally 4 bits are there. So how we need to complete? That means the 8081, 4041, 4041. So it going to complete from 0 to the 15. And third column, that means our third row, we need to use as the 2021, 2021. And in our last row, 0101. So like that, we need to complete in our binary equivalent. And after knowing the answer, that is 11001 and 10011. Yeah. First of all, I am going to find out the ones complement of the smallest number. So now this is the smallest number. So as we know that, I am going to start the step 1. So first of all, the smallest number, I am going to find out our complement, ones complement of the smallest number. So 10011. How to get the ones complement of this number? As we know that, that means by changing all the zeros to ones and all the ones to the zero. So like that, we can find out the ones complement of any number. Now the ones complement of this number as the our 0 1 1 0 0, correct? No. So this is the first step. Now just I completed the first step. Find the ones complement of the smallest number, and second one, add ones complement to the larger number. As we know that this is the answer of the first step. Now I am going to take such answer 0 1 1 0 0, and later whatever the largest number is there, such one I need to add to or add with the smallest number. Okay, so 1 1 and later 0 0 1. So ellarige artha aita ee number ellinda takkondu? ಯಾಕೆಂದ್ರೆ ನಮಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿದೆ, ನಮಗೆ ಒಂದು ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಆ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನಂಬರ್ ಇದೆ. ಸೊ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಲ್ ವಿ ನೀಡ್ ಟು ಫೈಂಡ್ ಔಟ್ ವಿಚ್ ಎವರ್ ಇಸ್ ದಿ ಲಾರ್ಜೆಸ್ಟ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ವಿಚ್ ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ ದಿ ಸ್ಮಾಲೆಸ್ಟ್ ನಂಬರ್. ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಫೈಂಡಿಂಗ್ ದಿ ಸ್ಮಾಲೆಸ್ಟ್ ಆಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಆಸ್ ದಿ ಲಾರ್ಜೆಸ್ಟ್ ನಂಬರ್, ನಾವು ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಲ್ ಐ ನೀಡ್ ಟು ಸೆಲೆಕ್ಟ್ ದಿ ಸ್ಮಾಲೆಸ್ಟ್ ನಂಬರ್. ಆಸ್ ವಿ ನೋ ದಟ್ ದಿ ಹೆಡ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಇಸ್ ದಿ ಸಬ್ಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಎ ಸ್ಮಾಲರ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಎ ಲಾರ್ಜರ್ ನಂಬರ್. ಸೊ ನಾವು ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಸೆಲೆಕ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ದಿ ಸ್ಮಾಲೆಸ್ಟ್ ನಂಬರ್, such number we need to convert into the ones complement, correct? No. Yalli 0 ide alli 1 hakudu, yalli 1 ide alli 0. Hagadre namma first step illi agide. Later second step alli yen helta idare, second one, add ones complement to the larger number. Okay, whatever the answer of the first step, we need to take it, we need to use in our second step, and also with that we need to add the largest value also. Clear this one? Now when you are going to add this number 0 plus 1, the value is 1. 0 plus 0, as we know that the value is 0. We already completed one binary arithmetic table, correct? No. And I already said 1 plus 1 in our binary arithmetic only. 1 plus 1, the value is the 10. 1 plus 1 plus 1, that is equal to 11. I am going to tell in our binary arithmetic, binary addition. Okay, kya? And later 0 plus 1, the value is 1. 0 plus 0, the value is 0. 1 plus 0, the value is 1. 1 plus 1, the value is the 10, correct? No. So 1 is carry here, and 1 plus 1, the value is 10. Clear this part? The value is the 10. Now this is the answer of the second step, that means add ones complement to the larger number. So this is our larger number we added with the our first answer, correct? No. And later the third step, remove the final carry. Okay, whatever the answer is there, we need to remove the final carry and again add it to the result. And this step, whatever the we are going to remove such carry and again need to add to the result, this step is called as the end around carry. Clear this point here? End around carry. Now again we need to add it. 1 plus 1, the value is 10. Okay, so 1 is carry. 0 plus 1, the value is 1. 1 as it is here, and 0 0. So this is the answer about our one's complement of the smaller number from a larger number. Otherwise, you can write the answer as the 0110. Clear this point here? So how we are going to find out whether our answer is proper or not? As we know that the 1001 that is equal to 9 and 0011 that is equal to 3. When you are going to subtract 9 minus 3, the answer is equal to 6. Correct? No. When you are subtracting the 9 minus 3, that means the answer will get as the 6. When you are going to find out in our hexadecimal table, the 6th value will get as the 0110. Clear this part here? So 00110, or we can write the answer as the 0110. So clear this point, how we are completing in this case? Okay, now after completing, now let's will complete the last example about our subtracting a smaller number from a larger number. Hagadre ee question alli namge ondu question kottidare. So just only 10 and next number is 5 base of 2. So that means sure, is it possible to make subtracting a smaller number from a larger number? No, it not possible. That means such number, first of all, we need to divide by 2. Correct? No, he get directly aage kotre number anu, no need to make the division by 2 here. But if they provide the number, maybe the 10, 5, 7, 3, 4, like that here, that means sure we need to make the divide by 2. So when you are going to divide, 2 5s are 10. Correct? No, 2 5s are 10. So no any remainder part. And later next one, 2 2s are 4. That means 1 is the remainder. And 2 1s are 2. That means no any remainder here. And later next one after that. Later next one, we need to divide such number until the quotient become 0. Clear this one? So just we need to divide it. So finally, we'll get the answer of the 10 divided by 2. The answer is the 1010. Clear this one? 1010 here. So this is the answer of the 10 after divide by 2. And later when you are going to take the number 5, so 2 2s are 4. 1 is the remainder. 2 1s are 2. 0 is the remainder. And later next one, the 1 it's not going correct now by 2 here. So that means we need to add the 0, and such one we need to take it here. So we can say that after the divide by 2, the number 5 later words will get the value as the our 101. Actual value is 101, but here we know that 4 digits are there. So just to complete as in 4 digit, I am going to add the 0. So final answer of 5 is equal to 0101. Nimge gottide nan hege takkondidene. Correct? No, I started from MSB to the LSB, so I completed 0101, and this number also the same here, 1010. So actual here 4 numbers are there. So just to complete the correct grouping, okay, 4 bits, just I taken the next value. Okay, now let's the step 1. In case of the step 1, first of all, I am going to take the 1's complement of the smallest number. Whether 10 is the smallest or 5 is the smallest, 5 is the smallest. So we can say that such 5 contain the number that is the answer 0101. Correct? No. And when you are going to take or determine or find the 1's complement of the smallest number, the answer is the 1010. Correct? No. So this is the answer of the first step. As we know that maybe 1 is there, need to convert to the 0. 0 is there, need to convert to 1. Okay. Now later next one, second step. In our second step, add 1's complement to the largest number. So we know that the largest number is 1010, and whatever the answer we got in our first step, the answer is the same, 1010. So both answer I am going to add it here. And later next one, 0 plus 0, the value is 0. 1 plus 1, the value is 10. 1 is the carry. Okay, so 1 and 1 plus 1, the value is 10. So this is the answer of the second step. Now let's we'll go for the third step. What about the third step? Remove the final carry. Clear this point here? Remove the final carry and add it to the result. Remove the final carry and add it to the result. So 0 plus 1, the value is 1, 0 as it is, no any problem. Directly we can add the value, correct? No. So this is the answer about our the answer of the subtracting a smaller number from larger number by using the example 3, 10 minus 5. So as we know that when you are going to subtract the 10 value minus 5, that means the answer will get as the 10 minus 5. The answer is the subtraction will get the answer as the 5. So when you are going to find out, we'll get the answer 0101, correct? No. So like that we can say that whether our answer is proper or not. So clear? No. About our subtraction, subtracting a smaller number from a larger number, first of all find one's complement of the smallest number, second add one's complement to the larger number, remove the final carry and add it to the result. Now after completing the subtraction using one's complement, the smaller number from a larger number, now let's after that we are going to complete the second concept. The second concept is the subtraction using one's complement, but the main point is the subtracting a larger number from a smaller number. First of all, what we completed, the first we completed the same thing, there is no any changes in one's complement, but I completed the first one is the smaller number from a larger number. Now I am going to complete the larger number from a smaller number. Artha aitha ellarige? Modlige now hege complete madido, smaller number in the larger number ige martidive. First of all we need to find out the smallest number, but now we are not in the same concept. Now just we changed the concept. The concept heading is the subtracting a larger number from a smaller number. Now let's what are the steps we need to follow. First of all, the first step is the find one's complement of the largest number. Clear this point? Find one's complement of the largest number. Second, add one's complement to the smallest number. Clear this one? Just a reverse of our first step. Whatever we completed, it just only the reverse of this step here. So find one's complement of the largest number. Second, add one's complement to the smallest number or smaller number. But third one, there will be no carry. Clear this point? It is not like our first step. There will be no carry. Recomplement the answer and insert a negative sign to get the answer, or to get the answer or in front of the answer. Now let's, I am going to find out the answer. So first of all, we know that the question, subtract 52 from 25 using one's complement method. Okay, they are not providing. You have to convert, you have to solve such program or problem by using largest to smallest, smallest to largest. We need to find out, okay, in this case here. So we can say that now first of all, in this case we know that the first number is the largest number, correct? No. The first number is the largest number and second number is the smallest number. But in case, in this case we can say that now subtract 52 from 25 using one's complement method. Now this is the concept of the larger number from a smaller number. Now let's, here directly the number is there, that means such number we need to divide by 2. So 52, when you are going to divide the number 52 by 2, that means 26 are 52, 0 is the remainder. And when you are going to divide 26, 2 13s are 26, 0 is the remainder. 2 6 are 12, 1 is the remainder. 2 3s are 6, 0 is the remainder. And 2 1s are 2 in this case. So 1 is the remainder. As we know that the 1 value not will go by 2. So we need to divide. That means here such we need to use the value 0 and such 1 we need to write it here. So finally we can say that the MSB to the LSB answer as the 52 as 110 110 100. So 110 100. So this is the answer. So clear this point. Okay, now just only the number 52 is there. With that one more number, the number is the 25. So 25 I need to divide by 2. So 2 12s are 24, 1 is the remainder, 2 6s are 12, so 0 is the remainder, 2 3s are 6, 0 is the remainder. Correct? Now everything, if it is going by divide by 2, means sure we need to write no remainder, that is equal to 0. And 2 1s are 2, 1 is the remainder. And finally here we can say that this 0, okay, kya this 0, so that means we can say that such one we need to write it here. So the answer of the 25, that is 11001. Okay, so 11001 in this case here. Now first of all I am going to write the first step. Okay, now the first step, after completing, after dividing the number 25 and 52 by 2, we will get some of the values, and by taking such value I am going to use all those step. This step 1, find 1's complement of the largest number. There is no any problem. We can say that when you are going to know 52 and 25, the 52 is the largest number. So I am going to take the 52, I am writing the value, whatever the value I got as the MSB to the LSB, the same value I am writing here. And later next one, now find 1's complement of the largest number. Now such value we need to convert to the 1's complement. So 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1. So this is the answer of the first step. Correct? No, kya? This is the answer of the first step. That means finds 1's complement of the largest number. Now the second step. What about the second step? The second step, add 1's complement to the smallest number. E banda answer anno. Now 0, 0, 1. 1011 takonda nantra yava value takolbeko, this value 25 value 0011. Clear this point here? 0011. So this answer we need to take. Clear this one? What about the answer where I got this answer? So the 52, find the 1's complement of the number 52. So this is the answer of the 1's complement of the number. And later whatever the number is that, now such number I am going to use the second step, and 1's complement to the largest, that means 1's complement to the smallest number. So now when you are going to add 1 plus 1, the value is 10. Okay, and later next one is 1 plus 1, the value is 10, 1 is carry, 1 plus 1, the value is 10. So 1 is carry, so here 1 directly we can write, 1 plus 1, the value is 10. So 1 is carry, 1 plus 1, the value is 10. That means this is the answer. Correct? No, kya? So this is the answer of the second step. Now later next one is about our third step. Now the third step, there will be no carry. That means we no need to use the rules of the first step. Whatever the concept we used here, there is no any equal to the concept. So there will be no carry. Therefore we complement the answer. Okay, we need to re-complement the answer. That means re-complement the answer means take the 1's complement of the answer, re-complement. Okay, so the re-complement answer is the 0. Yava answer is the re-complement takolta idene e banda addition value. Clear this one? So 0, 11011. So re-complement the answer and insert a negative sign to get the answer. That means we need to insert a negative sign in front of it. So this is the answer about our subtracting a larger number from a smaller number. So clear this point here. What about the concept about our subtracting a larger number from a smaller number? So we can say that find 1's complement of the largest number. Second, add 1's complement to the smallest number. And third one, there will be no carry. Re-complement the answer and insert a negative sign in front of it. So clear? No? What about these steps here? So okay, thank you for watching this video.
Don't forget to like our video and subscribe our YouTube channel for all the updates.